In this video, we're going to start the CUDA Software Infinite Geometry free worksheet Spheres. Our direction in this first section is to find the surface area of each figure and to round our answer to the nearest tenth if necessary. There's a simple formula for the surface area of a sphere. It's that surface area is equal to 4 times pi, or 4 pi, times the radius squared. That is the surface area of a sphere. So let's get started with number 1. And number 1, our radius r is equal to 3 feet. So for surface area, we'll have 4 times pi times 3 feet squared. So simplifying this, we'll get 4 times pi, 3 squared is 9, so that'll be times 9 feet squared, since 3 feet times 3 feet is 9 feet squared. Now we can multiply 4 to 9 to get 36, and then multiply that by pi to get 36 times pi feet squared. So when we type that into our calculators, 36 times pi, we're going to get 113.09. But remember, we're rounding to the nearest tenth, so that's 113.1 feet squared for the surface area of the sphere in number 1. In number 2, remembering our formula, surface area equals 4 times pi times r squared, where r is the radius. And number 2, they don't give us the radius, they give us the diameter. And we know that the radius r is equal to 1/2 of the diameter, or the diameter divided by 2. So r is going to equal 12 centimeters divided by 2. 12 divided by 2 is 6, so r is equal to 6 centimeters. Now we'll plug r into our surface area formula. 4 times pi times r squared, which is 6 centimeters squared. That'll be 4 times pi times 6 centimeters squared is 6 times 6, which is 36, and that's 36 centimeters squared. Because centimeters times centimeters is centimeters squared, and 6 times 6 is 36. 4 times 36 is 144, and then we're going to multiply that by pi to get the surface area in centimeters squared. So 144 times pi is equal to 452.38, which rounds to 452.4, and that's centimeters squared for the surface area. And if you're confused on what pi is a number that's equal to 3.141, and then it's 59265, and so on. So there's many other decimals after that, but it's usually safe to round pi to 3.1416. So if you don't have pi on your calculator, type in 144 times 3.1416, and you'll get 452.39, which rounds to 452.4. So again, if pi is not on your calculator, use its rounded decimal, 3.1416. Surface area equals 4 times pi times r squared. Our diameter d is 15.6 inches, and r is equal to 1/2 of d, or d divided by 2. So 15.6 divided by 2 will give us r, and that is 7.8. So if r is equal to 7.8, we'll plug that into our formula. 4 times pi times 7.8 squared. 7.8 squared is equal to 60.84. So we'll have 4 times pi times 60.84. Multiplying 60.84 to 4, we'll get 243.36 times pi. And we multiply that, we'll get 764.53, which rounds to 764.5, and our units, if diameter and radius are in inches, for area, that will be inches squared. So 764.5 inches squared is our solution in number 3. In number 4, they give us a radius of 7 centimeters. So we're going to plug in 7 for r. So that's 4 times pi times 7 centimeters squared. That'll give us 4 times pi, 7 squared is 49, and centimeters squared is centimeters squared. So 4 times pi times 49 centimeters squared. 4 times 49 is equal to 196, and we're multiplying that by pi, and our units is still centimeters squared. So 196 times pi is equal to 615.75, which rounds to 615.8 centimeters squared. That is the surface area in number 4. Our radius in number 5 is 8 inches. So surface area is going to be in inches squared. So we'll have 4 times pi, plugging 8 in for r and squaring that. That'll be 4 times pi times 64. 64 times 4 is 256, and we're multiplying that by pi. 256 times pi will give us 804.24, which rounds to 804.2, and this is inches squared. In number 6, we can see that our radius is equal to 10 miles. So plugging 10 miles in for r, we'll have 4 times pi times 10 miles squared. So that'll be 4 times pi times 100 miles squared. Since 10 squared is 100, and then the units, miles, if we were squaring that unit, multiplying miles by miles, we would get miles squared. So our units are miles squared for the surface area. 4 times 100 is 400, and we still have to multiply that by pi to get the surface area in miles squared. 400 times pi is 1,256.63, which rounds to 0.6 miles squared. And for the last two problems on this worksheet, number 7 and 8, we're not given a diagram, we're just given the measurements in words. And before I go over the answer to these last two problems, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. So hopefully that you've done that, let's go over number 7. We're still dealing with the sphere, and we're finding the surface area of that sphere. So remember, surface area for a sphere is 4 times pi times the radius r squared. So it tells us that we have a sphere with a diameter of 6.2 inches. The radius is equal to half the diameter, or the diameter divided by 2. So if a diameter is 6.2 inches, we're going to take 6.2 and divide that by 2 to get our radius of 3.1. So typing 3.1, r, in for our formula, we'll have 4 times pi times 3.1 squared. That'll be 4 times pi times 3.1 squared is 9.61. And when we multiply 9.61 by 4, we'll get 38.44, which we still need to multiply by pi to get the surface area. And when we multiply that by pi, we'll get 120.76, which rounds to 120.8. And if our diameter was in inches, our surface area is going to be in inches squared. So the surface area in number 7 is 120.8 inches squared. And lastly, number 8. We're still dealing with spheres, so surface area is going to be equal to 4 times pi times r squared. It gives us that the radius r is 10 miles. So 4 times pi times 10 miles squared. 4 times pi times 10 miles squared is the same as 4 times pi times 100 miles squared, since we're squaring the 10 and we're also squaring our units. So 4 times 100 is 400. So 400 pi miles squared is the surface area. And to simplify that, we'll multiply 400 by pi to get 1,256.63, which rounds to 1,256.6 miles squared for the surface area of a sphere with a radius of 10 miles. And with that, we wrap up this first section of this worksheet. Join me in the next video where we'll finish the second page, completing numbers 9 through 16, where we will be finding the volume of a sphere. However, before you move on to that, click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this video.